Good morning, everyone. It's snowing. Anyway, I was thinking about some moments in the past and a scary, well, not really scary. Well, it was at the time. I thought I was going to lose our foster license because of it. But our little six-year-old, she didn't want to clean something up. So we decided to put her in a timeout chair time. And so she didn't want to. And she said, I'm going to run away. And I knew it was nighttime and she doesn't like the dark. So I was like, well, if you run away, it's pretty dark outside. And she's like, that's fine. She put her coat on and I was thinking, well, she might actually go outside. So then I said, well, maybe you should take the dog. And I actually put a tracking device on the dog. Found out later, the battery was dead in it. But yeah, set that up. I made a big deal out of it, thinking that she wasn't actually going to do it. And waiting to call her bluff. And she did. She ran away. And I went outside to go look for her before she got out of the garage, and she took off, and I didn't see where she went. So I started freaking out, thinking, oh my gosh, this is how our foster care license ends, just like this. So I ran back and forth, and, you know, maybe a minute and a half later, our neighbor came around the corner looking for me, saying, hey, I think one of your kids is at our house. And so I thanked him and went over to his house and took her back home and kind of talked to her about running away, and actually she said the reason she went there is because when she first got to our house, I said, if there's anything that ever happens in our house, that you get scared or nervous or something happens, then go to our backdoor neighbor's house because it's a safe place, just like our house. And she actually listened to me. She went to the safe place. So that was good. But it's been 2 years yet since, and she hasn't tried to escape us yet. So that's a good thing, but just wanted to share that because there are some times where, there's some things that happen, and I didn't know if we should tell anyone. You know, at first it was like, maybe that's something we keep quiet. The next day they told the caseworker all about it, and the caseworker texted us about it, and, I realized after that, that anything that happens that you think is questionable, just tell the caseworker anyway, or don't hide it because it's going to get out anyway. Especially if you have older kids like we do. So I kind of changed the way I think about, you know, keeping things from people. I even question about, you know, the way we discipline, the way anything that we do. I'm like, hey, caseworker, is this okay? Is that okay? Because in the beginning, I didn't know what was okay and what wasn't okay. So I always run it by your caseworker to make sure. But now that we're into it, I know what to do and what not to do. And yeah, little things like that. But anyway, have a great day, and yeah, keep it up.